From Creamer Media in Johannesburg, this is The Real Economy Report. Middleburg-based Columbus Stainless aims to remain committed to the growing domestic stainless steel market, while the South African Stainless Steel Development Association believes that 2018 may be the year to break the downward trend of consumption in South Africa. Simone Lietke tells us more.
While a mill like Columbus Stainless has a big entry barrier, CEO Lucian Matthews explains to Engineering News after a tour of the 1 million ton a year plant that the company is able to compete internationally while remaining committed to growing the domestic market for stainless steel.
A mill like this has a big entry barrier. As you've seen today, it's a big investment required for a mill like this. And in the 1990s, when this expansion was done, the size was about 500,000 tons per year of throughput. And today the typical volume is about 1 million tons for a plant to be competitive, and we're more or less at the 1 million ton level now, which is the level you need to be to compete. And the challenge that comes with that is that the South African market consumption is only about 120 to 150,000 tons of flat product, and obviously the rest of that product needs to be exported. So being a big mill like this, you need to have the local market and export. So you have to be able to compete internationally with international players. So that is quite a challenge for us as a mill like this. We spend a lot of time developing the South African market so that we can try and sell more local. But the problem is that your size of investment requires you to be about a million tons. The Chinese nowadays are building about 3 million ton per annum plants, so you know, you need volume to dilute the costs.
Commenting on recent political developments across South Africa and its effect on the stainless steel industry, Matthews remains hopeful of a positive effect on both the industry and the economy at large.
I think, you know, one is quite, you know, it's a good result, and we hope and wish that it will help with the economic situation. The jobs that we require in the local community is huge, and we really need the economy to start, kickstart again and start moving.
While Columbus has been around for about 50 years, Matthew says that the company is known for developing and introducing new grades into the market. He further enthused about some of the company's projects for clients such as the Passenger Rail Agency of South Africa, or PRASA.
Columbus has been around for 50 years, and we have been supporting the local stainless steel market, working with SASDA very closely to develop the market, and they are also our voice from the customers back to the mill, what is required or where the trends are in the local market. So we built and expanded the local market. Columbus Stainless has been known for developing and introducing new grades into the market, which a new manufacturer requires, or new products or new projects. And so far we've localized 301. It's a grade that will be used by PRASA for the PRASA trains. The trains that have been built in Brazil were actually built with Columbus Stainless's material, which was exported for trial purposes so they can see. And we're excited. We hope that the PRASA project, you know, starts up this year and starts building trains, and that will be a big development. In the rest of it, we support the local market where there are people that can export competitively. We talk with them regularly, and if they need any help from us, technical or commercial, then we work closely with them to make sure we all remain competitive. And we also keep working with the local market a lot. One focus that has come in the last 2 or 3 years in Columbus is Africa. So we're putting a lot of effort into Africa now to understand the expected growth in Africa and to make sure that South Africa, you know, is actually present, whether it's us selling our flat product in those countries or whether we're going to support the local fabricators or manufacturers of goods to export. We're keen to work with people in that, and we will support them in that sense.
However, Matthews adds that the development of the local community in Middleburg remains a key focus for the company. Education and training, among others, are some of the key themes of their initiatives.
If I just reflect on the last 10 years, what Columbus has done is we focused the effort in the community around a central theme, And we decided that the best thing for the community is to focus on education. So we help schools where we can, you know, with fundraising or sponsorships and things like that. But the idea is that they should look after themselves. And then what we do is spend a lot of time with the children, educating them or asking them to come here to see what kind of jobs you would find in a big manufacturing industry. We show them what you would do if you're an artisan, what would you do if you're an engineer, an accountant, a lawyer in a big company, HR people. So we do a lot of that counseling and telling them how to do it and what to do. And then one program which we started to look for ourselves was a training program. And we've developed that program to train operators for our plant. As you know, walking through, it's a semi-automated plant. And we needed operators that have the skills to work remotely. So they can sit in a pulpit or at an entry or exit desk, as we call them, and control equipment far away. And we started courses to train learner steel makers. We also train our own artisans, so fitters, boiler makers, welding people. And that program is some classroom, and then it's practical training inside the factory. So after 2 or 3 years, the learners finish with a certificate or a qualification and practical experience.
After having gone through a rough time, Matthews further noted the company has now returned to being profitable.
We've been here for 50 years and we've gone through some very tough cycles, ups and downs, and after the market collapse in 2009, Columbus was in a very difficult situation. But as we've done before, we managed to turn the business around. And the last 4 years, we've returned to profitable. We also went from a capacity utilization of about 60% to back up to about 85-90% end of 2017 or in 2017. And we've established now a record again of being profitable for 3 or 4 years with good returns. And because of that, we're now starting to think of what is in the future and what we will do. What has already been approved is another cut-to-length or slitting and cutting line, which will be installed later this year and early next year. We're also busy now with a project which will increase the melting capacity. So we're thinking of putting in a ladle furnace there. And expansions after that is still, you know, we're part of an international group of Cerinox. And we are discussing with the directors about what is the future in 3 or 4 years from now when the next sort of capital budget comes up for discussion.
A positive sentiment for the industry is further supported by SASDA CEO John Tarboten, who says that the latest member survey shows a possibility of 2018 breaking the downward trend of stainless steel consumption.
2017, we saw about a 5.6% drop in apparent consumption compared to 2016. We hit a peak level in 2014, and we've dropped about 28% from 2014 to 2017. So our latest survey seems to show that this year could break that downward trend and we could start seeing an increase again. We have a SASDA expectations index where 50 separates expansion from contraction. And for the last few months of last year, there was an improvement, but it was still sitting around the 50-point mark. In January, that increased to 65, and in February, it's now sitting at about 71. So the expectations for this year are higher than they have been since the survey began 2 years ago.
The positive sentiment has, however, not yet translated into an increase of order quantities.
What our members are saying is that they're certainly a lot busier in terms of quotes and inquiries and that sort of thing, but it has not yet translated into actual order quantities increasing. And in fact, the level of orders for the first 2 months of this year are lower than it was for the last few months of last year. So the order quantities are actually lower. So that confidence and that optimism is yet to translate into increased order levels.
That's Creamer Media's Real Economy Report. Join us again next week for more news and insights into South Africa's real economy.